Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, I'll take you through the process of adding and subtracting vectors on the MCAT. In the last video, we talked about vectors and vector components, but an MCAT question may come up where you're given more than one vector and you have to put them together. You can find my entire series on MCAT Physics Translational Motion by visiting my website, leiaforsci.com/MCATphysics. Now this sounds like a complicated topic unless you understand what's going on and understand how to break it up. A vector is simply a line that goes from A to B. And if you have more than one vector, imagine that you go from A to B, and then you're traveling from B to C. For example, imagine that this diagram represents a city grid where we have multiple blocks, each at a length of 10 meters. If I start at point A and walk to point C, I walked a total of 20 meters because I covered the distance of two city blocks. That's my one vector. However, what if I start at point D, walk for 10 meters and stop at point E, and then walk 10 more meters and stop at point F? What I really did was walk a total distance from D through F for 20 meters. So we took one vector and we added it to the second vector to get our total or resultant vector. When you're adding vectors that are parallel to each other or going in the same direction, you simply add the values. So in the example of going from D through F, we had vector D through E plus vector E through F, that's 10 meters plus 10 meters for a total distance of 20 meters. This is called the head-to-tail method, but students often confuse what's going on. So simply think of the arrow this way. A vector is simply an arrow where the tail of the arrow is where you start and the head of the arrow is where you wind up. If you have one vector, meaning you stop, you have that arrow head, and then you start again, it only makes logical sense to start again from where you ended, and that's your new tail, and once again when you stop, that's your new head. That's the idea of the head-to-tail method, because the second tail immediately follows that first head. If you see positives and negatives, that can sometimes get confusing. I've heard it taught that a positive vector means that you put head to tail, but a negative vector is tail to tail or head to head. I personally find that confusing. Don't think of your signs as a way to turn your arrow. Instead, think of it as a direction. In referring to this grid, we can say that the negative x direction is left, the positive x direction is to the right. Going north, that's the positive y direction, and south is the negative y direction. So if I start out at point A and have my first vector 20 meters to the right at point B, and then I stop at point B and change directions going 10 meters to the left, then yes, I wind up having positive 20 because I walk to the right, negative 10 because I walk to the left, and that gives me a resultant vector of 20 minus 10 equals 10 meters. The idea of drawing this head-to-head to me is personally confusing. So instead, I have my first vector 20 meters to the right, my second vector 10 meters to the left, and yes, my resultant vector is only 10 meters because I subtracted 10 from my initial 20. The same thing happens in the y direction. If I start out here at point A and then travel negative 20 meters in the y direction, meaning 20 meters south, I start with negative 20, and then if I choose to walk 20 meters up, that's positive 20, positive being the up direction, and my total displacement is 0 because I ultimately wound up where I started, and we can prove this mathematically because negative 20 plus 20 is equal to 0. From these examples, you can see that if we have vectors pointing in the same direction, we add them. If they're pointing in opposite directions, you wind up subtracting. So what happens if I start at point A, walk 10 meters to the right, stop at point B, and then walk 10 meters north to stop at point C? What is my total displacement? I don't subtract because I'm not walking backwards. I don't add them because I'm not walking in the same direction. Think of the ultimate displacement on this city grid as the expression as the crow flies. If a crow started out at point A and flew over all the buildings to wind up at point C, the crow is traveling at that diagonal, and the total displacement is the exact distance between A to C, regardless of the path traveled. And this is where the idea of vector components comes in. If you want to find the total distance traveled, you have to take your vector 1 and turn it into v1x and v1y. Then you take your vector 2 and turn it into v2x and v2y. And then to get the total, we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem. First, we have to find the total x. So we'll take the sum of x is equal to x1 plus x2. The sum of y is equal to y1 plus y2. This will give us our new x and our new y. And then we'll use the Pythagorean theorem, which is the formula x squared plus y squared is equal to z squared. You may also see this as a squared plus b squared is equal to c squared. Since we're solving for c, or z, we take the square root to cancel out the square, and that means the ultimate resultant is simply the square root of a squared plus b squared, or the square root of x squared plus y squared. Going back to our example, this is relatively simple, because the first vector, v1x is equal to 10 meters, v1y is equal to 0 because we've only traveled in the x direction. The second vector, we have v2x is equal to 0 because we traveled north, so we have nothing in the x direction. But v2y is equal to 10 meters because we traveled 10 meters north. Now be very careful, I'm using v to represent vector, not velocity. This is just our walking vector. Adding our vectors, x1 equals 10, x2 is 0, so x is really just 10 meters. y1 equals 0, y2 is 10, once again we have 10 meters. Plugging our numbers into this equation, we have the resultant is equal to the square root of x squared, or 10 squared, plus y squared, which is 10 squared again. 10 squared is 100, plus 100 is equal to the square root of 200. Remember on the MCAT, you cannot use a calculator. So we want to break this up into something that we can recognize. I don't know the square root of 200, but the square root of 200 is equal to the square root of 2 times the square root of 100. The square root of 2 is something you should memorize, and that is equal to 1.4. The square root of 100 is equal to 10, and so our answer is 1.4 times 10. We'll use the times 10 trick, moving our decimal over one space to the right, and that gives me an answer of 14 meters total as the crow flies, or a resultant of 14 meters. If you're not comfortable with a math trick I used here, go back to my MCAT math videos on my website at leahfirstsci.com/MCATmath. You can also download my MCAT math cheat sheet, which gives you a lot of the different mathematical values that you have to memorize for the MCAT. Be sure to join me in the next video, where I take you through the process of adding vectors that are not clean in the x and y direction, making you use trigonometry to calculate the x and y components of each vector before you add them.
Are you stuck on a specific MCAT topic? I offer private online tutoring where I focus on your needs to strengthen your individual weaknesses. Tutoring details can be found using the link below or by visiting my website, leahfirstsci.com/MCATtutor. Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, The MCAT Exam Strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at MCATExamStrategy.com. By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, MCATExamStrategy.com.